I'm Franchesca Ramsey, and Election Day is right around the corner, and we're either going to be screaming with excitement or clutching our uteruses in absolute terror or trying to book that U-Haul to get the F out of here. So I am here to help with some of those inevitable, cringeworthy, awkward conversations that are bound to happen with friends and family when it comes time to talk about politics. So your girlfriend says that you're not a feminist if you don't vote for Hillary Clinton. Ooh, sounds like someone doesn't know what a feminist is. Being a feminist is all about giving women the right to do what they want with their minds, their bodies, and their vote. And that also means that you don't have to vote for someone just because they're a woman. So your girlfriend tweets out hashtag all lives matter. What do you do after you block, unfollow, and delete? Just kidding. Kind of, not really. Here's the thing, All Lives Matter was just created to derail conversations about black folks and police brutality. Literally no one was using it before Black Lives Matter started trending on Twitter. And it's okay to focus a conversation on black people when it comes to this important issue. It's just like saying, save the rainforest doesn't mean screw all the other trees. It's okay to focus just on this problem. What do you and your girlfriends do if Donald Trump gets elected? Well, lots of people are saying that they might just pick up and move and leave the country. Here's the thing, moving is super expensive and I kind of love my apartment. I'm actually gonna just stay right here and make as much noise as possible because you don't get shit done if you run away. Hey ladies, I know election season feels really overwhelming, especially when all of these hard conversations are happening, but the only way to make real change is to get out there and vote. So make sure you're registered and make sure your friends and family are registered too.